Hi, morning everyone. I'm Aida from Setiawangsa.
Cik, kalau dulu zaman MIRC kita tanya ASL.
ASL, Aida, female and Setiawangsa. How about you, Pija? Where are you from?
Eh, apa? Ah, Pija,
Eh,
25
apa? Best.
tahun, female, Mutiara Damansara. Alrighty. Wow, ada almost 100 people that is in our session right now. Welcome, welcome again, everybody, to your Thermomix cooking experience with the Cook and Share branch. Alhamdulillah, it's a very good day, a very good morning. And do we have a show for all of us? Hari ni kita nak masak 6 macam benda. Sweet and savory. Semua dalam satu bowl. No problem. Okay, I eja savory tu bahasa orang Amerika. Baru sedar. So, today kita ada Farah. We have Dr. Nora dan juga Laila who's going to be showing us how to cook all of these amazing dishes that you all can try at home later. Or when your Thermomix masuk. Masuk pula sampai. And just to let you know, our upcoming events tomorrow, siapa yang dah dapat the Thermomix, we have an unboxing session. So your advisors would inform you what to do, where to go. As well as esok juga after unboxing, kita ada cook along. Cook along is when we go deeper into recipes, and Harlina and Shasha esok akan ajar how to make tahu belauk as well as apple nectarine lettuce pie. So don't miss out, ask from your advisor your Zoom registration link as well as recipe cards. Okay, so let's get started. Are you all ready? I hope you're ready and tulis in the chat that you are ready. Betul Fina, tadi teh tarik pun boleh buat tak salah you dengar. So let's see if we can make other things, six things that we're going to make today. A little bit about all of us today dekat advisor ni, we are from Cook and Share branch. My name is Afiza Halin. I've used Thermomix dah 12 tahun. Dah darjah 6 my Thermomix tu. And I've been advisor for a year. A year, 6 months, something like that lah. And it's been a rewarding journey, especially berkenalan dengan ramai orang. Okay. And menariknya kan about Thermomix ni is, kalau you Aida, how often do you masak setiap hari? Kalau korang lah boleh tak tulis dekat chat. How often do you cook per week?
Per week you guys. Kalau I memang cook daily because I have 4 kids at home. So memang nak tak nak kena juga suap anak-anak burung ni.
Anak-anak burung. Yanti every day, Fatin every day. Now daily with Thermomix. That's very nice, Fatin. And let's check out. We surveyed over 2,500 people and half of them masak on a daily basis. And seboleh-bolehnya, we want to be able to help everybody yang dalam pie chart ni. Sama ada you masak daily ke, rarely ke, 1 to 3 times or 4 to 6 times a day, there is always a way for Thermomix to help you cook at home. And then boleh tak nak tanya, what is important to you when you are cooking? Boleh tak letak kat dalam chat? I tengok ramai kita hari ni ada 100 people. Alhamdulillah, that's a very good point. So ada Zaila, ada Azrani. Why don't you put in the chat what is important to you bila you memasak? Aida, what's important to you bila you memasak?
For me, I think some may know that I'm a cancer fighter. I'm battling cancer now. So sebenarnya yang for me, what's important bila masak tu is healthy.
It's healthy.
Because of the current diet, so it must be healthy. And also kalau masak ni, I kena something yang senang lah for me. So that I don't have to berdiri lama and tunggu lama. So simple things.
Seboleh-bolehnya.
So, how about you, Bija?
Right? Just nice. I hari ni I select video. What's important to me when I'm cooking is that this little kenet, she's gonna eat healthy food, and while I'm cooking, tak ada minyak terkena kat dia ke. So I'm so happy dia memasak, dia memakan sambil kita benda yang healthy lah. So all the other people yang survey, they, what is it that they want to eat? To what is important to them when they are eating, cooking. Easy, healthy and fast. Kebanyakannya all the things that we saw in the chat session tadi. Alia nak sedap, mudah and tak kecah. Very nice. Okay.
Tak kecah, eh?
Very, inshallah boleh. So I just want to check, can you still see my weird screens? I was toggling around, patutnya dah tak kan?
Okay, it's good now, it's good.
Thank you. Alright. Okay, let's, very important for all of us, please stay through throughout the show. Kita akan ada quiz and akan ada hadiah. And we also have pre-hosting promotion. So let's get started with the Thermomix presentation itself. Not to let everybody know, Thermomix is all the way from Germany. Kalau I sebut Germany lah, Aida, what's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Kalau I kan, German is of course, for me is football. Maybe the and then also the technology, kereta-kereta dia kan, you know, all the European cars.
Betul, that's the first thing that comes to my mind, kereta, BMW especially. So we think about all these big brands with Germany because they come with high quality. So Thermomix is from a company called Vorwerk and it is based in Germany. And right now, Thermomix punya distributorship has gone across 85 countries globally. So it's not barang yang yang exclusive only for one country, but across the globe. It's a global community now. And it's a company that has been around for more than 135 years. So company macam ni lah that we want to be innovating kita punya product because it's going to be there, because it has been there very long, meaning that the service is also tip top and they're going to be there. Whether pandemic ke, financial crisis ke, they are there. Alright, and it is a company that has won so many awards that you can see over there. Banyak sangat sampai tak muat screen nak letak gambar award tu. And if we go to Thermomix itself, this Thermomix bukan barang yang baru viral last year ke this year. It's been around daripada tahun 60-an tau. And it started off like a little blender, memang literally kecil je blender ni. And then the Vorwerk company, they keep on asking themselves, what else can I do with this little blender? They thought, can I warm up food sambil I nak blend? And then became the first Thermomix. And then they keep on asking these kind of questions. And up until now, TM6 is the 9th generation of the Thermomix, which has more than 24 over function. And it is the original Super Kitchen. And we will see a little bit what it is. So it replaces over 24 cooking function. So boleh tak korang imagine dekat rumah sekarang, you kalau you nak masak ayam ke bawang ke, you akan bawa keluar knife, chopping board, your blender, you punya stove, you kena fikir how to use all of these appliances. And kononnya bila kita nak buat kek, you akan bawa keluar you punya mixer, you punya penimbang, and then bila nak buat topping kek tu, you bawa keluar you punya whip, apa ni, apa orang panggil ni Aida, yang whipping ni lah.
Hand mixer.
So bukan saja kena fikir macam mana nak pakai, but you also have to clean up all of these things. And dah clean up, kena pula simpan. Kalau slow cooker, imagine you ada slow cooker, you kena letak dekat kabinet bawah because berat. Kalau ada steamer, mungkin you letak dekat dalam pantry ke, dekat kabinet lain ke. But all of these things require usage, clean up and storage. But yet, kalau kita ada check Thermomix kita, the question that is asked is why you have 24 gadgets when you can have three, one. Hopefully dengan boleh klik jari je, you will also be able to get your own Thermomix. And bukan saja 24 function, it gets better and better by itself. Aida, how does this work?
So the thing about Thermomix, because it has an inbuilt software, so if any updates, kita just do an on-the-air update je. Just like our iPhone, tiba-tiba dia prompt, update the new iOS, for example. So same goes to the Thermomix. It gets better every day. All we need to do is just update and you get the latest function, the latest mode, the latest recipe. So everything is just at the fingertips here.
Cooking at your fingertips. Perfect. And we can also watch videos on your Thermomix. Nanti kita cerita sikit lagi lah about that one. And the Thermomix is available to you at, and the Thermomix, you can own your Thermomix at RM7,188 sahaja if you want to do full payment. However, you are also able to own your Thermomix with financing, 0% interest installment, as low as RM9 a day. So there are a lot of options for everybody to own one. Nanti kita go into a little bit detail. So nanti bila you dah own your Thermomix, you are going to bring back this unit that is going to be on your countertop every single day. And you akan memasak dengan the mixing bowl. Kita akan tengok Farah, Nora and Laila buat kejap lagi. Even nak masak nasi pun boleh. Kita tutup dia bila kita nak masak. And kalau kita nak steam, kita pakai kita punya Varoma. So all of these things, all this steamer dah ada kat sini, kita punya kuali dah ada kat sini, recipe book pun dah ada kat mana recipe book, nanti Laila nak tunjuk. All of this is included when you get your Thermomix. And menariknya, when you purchase Thermomix, you also boleh dapat free gift. Macam-macam free gift you boleh dapat. So we will talk in detail about this in the middle of the presentation kejap lagi. So let's start cooking, and we are going to start cooking dengan Cik Farah. So, hi Farah. Farah tak dengar. Farah dia ada gadget dia.
Okay, sekarang dengar.
Perfect, perfect.
Okay. Okay, hi everyone. Good morning. Okay, nama saya Farah. Saya dah jadi Thermomix Advisor since last year. So hari ni saya akan masak dua benda, actually nak buat dua benda, bukan masak, buat dua benda. First kita akan start dengan lemonade. But before that, kita ada berapa orang? 100 orang eh?
Yes, kita ada
okay, 1, before 4. That, okay, I nak minta tolong semua orang check time. Sekarang pukul berapa? Nanti I habis lemonade, I nak you all clock. Berapa minit I buat lemonade? Boleh tak?
Wow. Okay, I pasang stopwatch.
Okay, pasang stopwatch eh.
Oh, I pun dah buat lah.
Okay, buat eh. I start sekarang.
Okay.
Okay. I akan guna gula batu. Okay, gula batu. Ha, tengok ni. Gula batu. Lepas tu, I nak grind. Cuba teka. Berapa minit?
Cuba teka dalam chat. Berapa?
Cuba teka. Sebelum I pusing.
Advisor tak payahlah jawab.
2 second saja. Jom kita tengok. Jadi apa? Nampak tak berasap-rasap ni?
Nampak.
Wow. Nampak.
Best kan?
I'm always amazed with this even though I tengok selalu.
Okay. Sekarang I masukkan lemon. 2 biji lemon. Masukkan mint. Okay. Air lupa masuk.
You buat apa tadi Farah? You buat air apa?
Mint lemonade. Okay. Cuba tengok.
Aida, you tengah time kan sebab I punya stopwatch tak buka.
I punya stopwatch pun tak buka.
Okay. Tahu tak? I dah siap dah.
Okay. I nak figure out nak buka stopwatch. Dia dah siap.
Betul.
Lagi cepat daripada buat stopwatch kita ni.
Cuba tengok berapa minit. Berapa, siapa ada clock?
Ada. Wow,
ada 1 minute and 15 seconds. Wow.
Cepat tak?
Cepat sangat ni Farah.
Kan? So, kalau cepat macam ni, boleh boleh tak buat hari-hari?
Boleh. Cikgu automatically jawab macam cikgu. Boleh cikgu.
Cuba tengok. Tak sampai 2 minit, I dah dapat 1 jug ni.
Wow. Very nice lah kan? Farah. And this is mint lemonade pula tu. You boleh buat you punya variations, right? Apa lagi variation
lagi
you boleh buat?
I pernah dengar orang buat apa? Buat delima lemonade. I pernah dengar orang buat strawberry lemonade. Beside lemonade, you boleh buat lime pun boleh?
Limau kasturi. Minum dulu. Oh, boleh minum dulu. Oh. Wow.
Sedap sangat. Memang sedap.
Cepat sangat sampai I terkesima. I macam, okay, I thought I can have a breather. But
I rasakan masa I pusing tadi, 3 kelip mata je. Lepas tu, eh, dah siap.
Apa ni Farah? Okay, so okay. You tunjuk ni buat lemonade. Ada tak benda lain yang orang boleh benefit from the function yang you buat tadi? Apa yang you guna tadi tu?
Okay, I guna function tubuh. Okay, you tengok eh, dari, apa dia punya tubuh function ni dari gula batu ke icing sugar. So meaning dia punya motor ni sangat power. So you boleh grind, beside gula batu ni, you boleh grind your own coffee. You boleh buat you punya spice sendiri. Contohnya, I macam nak masak butter chicken. Indian punya style eh, bukan yang Chinese punya style. Butter chicken dia nak apa, garam masala. Kan garam masala tu kalau I pergi beli macam RM12 pakai secuk saja kan. Last kali keras buang. Betul tak?
Betul.
Lepas tu I selalu buat sendiri. Lepas tu lagi apa benda nak grind. Okay, I paling suka kan function tubuh ni. Sebab apa tau, I selalu beli gula kasar tau. Gula kasar ni I tengok harga dia RM2.80, RM2.50. Tapi caster sugar RM2 dalam RM4.80 sekali ganda. So bila ada Thermomix, I boleh save kat situ. I beli je gula kasar, I grind sikit, jadi gula caster. Grind 2-3 kali jadi icing sugar.
Very nice. Pai boleh tak tunjuk apa dah jadi dekat dalam the Thermomix bowl?
Oh, okay, boleh-boleh. Sorry, terlupa. Okay, I buka ni. Okay, nampak tak? Walaupun kita masuk walaupun kita masuk sekali dengan kulit-kulit, dia tak chop yang apa, dia punya putih tu, peak dia tu. Dia just chop dia punya apa, kita panggil apa dalam tu? Pulp eh?
Pulp, yes.
Yes. Dia just chop pulp. So, dia tak akan rasa pahit. So, sekarang kan zaman pandemik, kita kena, I rasa every morning minum apa, lemonade ni bagus tau. It's macam apa, vitamin C booster.
Saya sangat setuju. So, you hari-hari ke you minum air lemon?
Tak juga. Kadang tukar air orange. Kita buat, kita variety lah. Tak adalah hari-hari ni. Tapi I pernah dengar tau orang cakap kalau tak nak perut kita buncit, hari-hari minum air lemon.
Okay. Memang aku minum lemon je lepas ni sebab buncit sikit lah ni.
Biasa kan. Okay.
Thank you so much Farah. Okay, kita akan go back to Farah kejap lagi sebab dia nak tunjuk kita masak sayur. Semua healthy-healthy semua hari ni Farah. You enjoy your drink dulu no Farah. Kita pergi dekat Cik Laila Taha kita. Hi Laila, good morning. I suka sangat lah you punya setting. Korang suka tak setting Laila? Kalau you suka Laila punya kitchen, you tulis suka.
Thank you.
Now, what are you doing for us today, sayang?
I'm doing steam mantau buns and later I will be doing butter chicken. But sekejap. Hello, hi everyone. My name is Laila. I have been a Thermomix user and an advisor since early of this year. And why I believe Thermomix is because I always think that masak ni is something hard and therefore I macam tak berapa minat lah nak memasak. Ever since I had Thermomix, I don't think of it that way anymore because cooking is so easy with Thermomix and I will show you why kejap lagi. Okay, so let me just pick the recipe for the quick steam buns from Cookidoo, which is our online recipe library. Okay, here. So I dah save dah this under my bookmarks because it's one of our selalu buat lah sebab senang sangat. Okay, so here it is. Okay, before I start, can I ask our guest today, siapa yang tak pernah buat roti? Maybe because you think that susahlah nak buat roti, nak masak pun tak reti nak buat roti, apatah lagi. And might as well you beli ke? Okay, comment. Ada tak geng-geng I? Geng Aida juga kot.
Geng tak pernah buat roti.
Aida tak pandai masak dulu.
Ada Dini, Ili, Jihan. Semua ada yang takut nak handle yeast. Jom kita tengok macam mana.
Okay. Yeah, and I will be showing you macam nak buat ni sebab senang sangat. This is what we call guided cooking. Guided cooking ni is step by step. So you ikut je. As long as you're able to read, should be okay, insyaAllah. Okay, so open the lid. Now it's asking me to put in water. So as I pour in the water, your Thermomix ni dah jadi weighing scale. Okay, so you boleh nampak ni. Tuang dia. Okay. Ya, sikit lagi. Okay, dah letak tu. All you need to do is just click next. Click next, lepas tu dia suruh letak sugar. So directly je you masukkan, tak payah guna banyak-banyak bekas. Ni I guna banyak bekas lah. Kalau tak, you directly je tak adalah banyak benda nak basuh kan. Put in my sugar. And then click next. I letak my yeast. Okay. Okay. Click next. So senang je, ikut je. Ikut je the ingredients semua dia dah cakap how much you nak kena put in pun. It's already stated here.
Okay, so I'm just gonna put Pina in. Pina tanya, dia ada kiraan olive berapa oil. Gram kena masuk ke?
Yes, so dia tulis sini exactly 20 grams olive oil and that's what I put in. Give and take lah. Okay, 20 grams of olive oil and dia dah tulis lah exactly what how much ingredients you need to put. Okay, I click next. Sampai dia tulis sini, insert measuring cup into mixing bowl lid. Okay, so that's it's just asking you to tutup. So every step of the way, just follow je. Okay, next. And then guided cooking ni, dia dah even let you know how much time you need to do this action. So 1 minute, and then temperature, and the speed that you need to use. So all you need to do is just move the dial ni up to the speed, which is speed 2. Okay, so what am I doing here? I am activating the yeast. So with the precise temperature control, which is 37 degrees, that's how you activate your yeast. So, orang yang buat roti tahulah kalau nak buat traditionally, you need to rasa air itu suam. So memang kena celup-celup air lepas tu. And then you pun terfikirlah, okay, is this suam enough? Or is it sejuk ke, panas ke? Because If it's not the right temperature, that will spoil your yeast. So, ni first step of your roti pun you got it right already by the precise temperature control, which is 37. Okay, so
tadi ada Jihan. Jihan kata dia takut nak handle yeast. Jadi in this case, kalau tengok cara Laila handle yeast, Laila happy je.
Ya, yeah, I tak pernah handle yeast pun sebelum ni. Ikut je apa dia cakap. And you're able to, see? Okay, now dah habis dah 1 minute ke. Do you hear that sound? That's it calling you to attend to it. So you just click next. Alright, let me just open this. So dia suruh letak 250 grams of flour.
Tadi kalau perasan, Laila bila dia buka dia punya Thermomix tu, dia punya weighing scale ada berubah-ubah. It's so sensitive kan, Laila, kan?
Yes, it's very sensitive. It's very precise. So, you dah tak payahlah perlu gunakan penimbang ini. Mau tak payah keluarkan extra kitchen gadget, kan? Okay, I'm just putting next. One pinch of salt. But sometimes, it happened to me so many times. Keluarkan penimbang tu, alamak, bateri habis. So, tergendala lah nak masak tu. Okay. Just click next. Okay, asking you to insert measuring cup again into mixing bowl. Let's click next. Okay, before I move on to the next step, let me just ask everyone here pula. Siapa yang dah pernah buat roti? Siapa sini yang buat roti? Manually ke?
Pakai Thermomix ke tak ke?
Saya.
Kalau tak. How long does it take for you to knead your dough?
30 minit kalau guna bread maker.
Okay. Now, I am going to show you dengan Thermomix. Di sini dah set tau. This is 2 minutes and this wheat symbol is the kneading function. Okay, so let me just turn the dialer. So, dalam 2 minit ni, what it does is kneading function, dia ada interval mode. So, interval mode ni is when dia pusing clockwise in the stop. And dia pusing anti-clockwise. So it's bringing your dough back and forth. Macam mimicking kita punya uli dengan tangan lah. Tapi ni 2 minit je. And then that kneading function, what it does is it makes sure that you punya dough ni is mixed thoroughly and evenly lah. And that's how you get soft and smooth dough. Which something yang kadang-kadang kalau you buat kalau buat traditionally kan, kadang-kadang dengan letak tepungnya, dengan letak airnya, you don't know apa if you're going to get the right consistency the next time, kan? So with this, insyaAllah, because the consistent akan sentiasa jadi. And have a look at my my kitchen. How does your kitchen look like bila you buat roti? Sebab tak ada pun, tepung-tepung everywhere.
Tak ada tepung flying around kan?
Yes.
Tak berkecah macam Alia cakap tadi. Nak ni lah, nak cerita tadi masa I tanya siapa suka your kitchen. Ramailah juga cakap saya suka kitchen Laila.
Yo, malunya.
Marni, Tina, Kak, ada Hana. Lepas tu ada orang tanya tu studio ke kitchen.
But this is my dry kitchen. So dengan termomix, kitchen tu memang akan clean. This is actually where I put it every day, where I use it. Tak adalah bersipas-sipas, tak ada berminyak, tak payah risau pasal semua tu. Kalau I buat roti pun tepung tak ada everywhere, because and mentioning about what manually kan, you need practice and experience tau. So macam I bagi orang-orang yang luar sana yang tak pernah buat roti, dengan termomix senang je you boleh buat. Okay, alright, done. See, 2 minutes done. Okay, now I'm just going to transfer the dough, and let me show you how I transfer it. I'm just going to use a thermomet here. Alright, okay. Ta-da!
There you go.
That's how it looks like, okay? Now, I'm going to show you a little magic secret here. Just topple it. And then, what I'm doing is, I am unlocking the blade. Ta-da! So, blade dia boleh keluar. Senang sangat. So supaya bila you buat dough ke apa ke, senang je nak keluarkan.
Nak pas tu pasang balik pun senang. And yeah, your dough just came off.
Exactly. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Perfectly.
Okay. Boleh, you can touch the dough. It is so soft. It's so soft. Okay.
Nampak tadi masa you tarik dia tu. It looks good. It looks good.
Yes.
So, would siapa yang nak cuba buat roti macam Laila ni? Okay, cuba tulis dekat chat. Roti apa korang nak cuba buat first? Roti gardenia. Tapi sekarang dah kena panggil roti cap rumah korang lah. Tak boleh panggil roti gardenia dah.
Roti boy. Berebut-rebut.
Roti boy, roti paung, cinnamon rolls.
Cinnamon rolls. I
tapi Laila, selain daripada roti, apa lagi kita boleh buat pakai the kneading function you tu?
Okay, kneading function ni you boleh buat pizza dough. You boleh buat pasta, your own pasta. Lagi apa lagi ya? You boleh buat meatballs, your fish ball,
nuggets.
Yes, chicken nuggets. Yes, macam-macam lagi boleh buat. Now I'm just shaping it. I buat simple je. Yelah, daripada orang yang tak pernah buat langsung kan, jadilah ni. So you can get really creative. I seen apa? Minion Paula, Rose lah.
Ya, Kak Atina kata best sangat nak buat bomboloni.
Bomboloni.
Boleh nyanyi.
Yeah. Very segala cool. Buns lah. That's why you, sekarang kita tak boleh keluar pun kan. So tak payah nak rely nak pergi bakery to get all sorts of buns and roti segala benda.
So kalau perasan tadi macam Laila tolong tunjuk kat kita macam mana nak telangkup and buka, how to place your bowl, how to use the kneading mode, all of that kita as advisor akan ajar you during your unboxing session. Betul tak Laila?
That's the dedication. Which is happening tomorrow. Yes.
Happening tomorrow.
Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I am going to cut it. Put it in an accessory that you'll get together with your thermomix. This is called a varoma. This is a steaming tray. Okay, so I nak potong guna our award-winning spatula. So, what is award-winning?
Apa award-winning tu?
Sebab design dia unique sangat. Bila you letak on your table, tak adalah dia, tengok, it stays put. Dia tak ada goncang-goncang, and then you get your tabletop dirty. That's how I maintain my kitchen to be so clean. Okay, so now I'm just going to cut. So spatula ni banyak sangat uses dia. You boleh guna untuk kacang masak. So yang ni I tengah guna untuk potong my mantau buns. Okay. So yeah, I'm just going to put it on the tray macam ni. Dia ada dua atas dan bawah. Like that. I'll be doing this and then nanti I akan tunjuk how I steam it together while I make my the chicken.
Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, over
Laila.
To you, Pija and Aida.
Very, very good. Did you guys like what Laila showed us how to make your own pau? Basically, dia tengah buat pau lah tu eh. Kalau suka, tengok what Laila did, tulis pau. Pau, pau, pau. I nak tengok banyak-banyak pau dekat dalam kita
pau,
punya
pau,
chat.
Pau, pau, pau.
And nanti sekarang kita takkan rindu Laila lama sangat sebab dia akan tunjuk kat kita macam mana nak buat butter chicken kejap lagi. So kita akan beralih ke Dr. Nora and in the meantime, Laila akan habiskan buat her pau and dia akan start sikit lah step untuk butter chicken. So now kita pergi kat Dr. Nora, a real doctor korang, bukan Dr. Memem. Hi Dr. Nora, apa khabar?
Hai Pija, khabar baik? Okay. Assalamualaikum semua. Saya advisor Nora. Dah jadi advisor 1.5 tahun dah lebih kurang. Okay. So hari ni kita nak buat bihun goreng. Yes. Bihun goreng dalam blender. Pernah dengar tak?
I pernah lah. Okay. Tapi orang lain mungkin tak pernah.
Okay. So kita buat tak guna cookie dough. Cookie dough pun ada menu bihun goreng. Tapi saya nak buat manual. Okay. Okay, kita buka je measuring cup ni sebab dia ada lubang kat sini. So saya suka garlic banyak sikit ya, masuk dalam 4-5 belas ya. And then 2-3 biji bawang merah, tapi saya tak ada bawang merah kecil. Pakai dia bawang besar sebiji ni, as long as the size can fit in the measuring cup punya hole ni, masuk je. Okay. Right, so sekarang kita nak blending. Sekejap sahaja, dalam 5 second.
Sementara tu, I tanya pau-pau tadi, ramai jawab. Siap ada kata, pau lah laki korang cepat ambil TM6. Cute sangat, Datuk Syah.
Syah, suruh pau lah.
Okay, so 5 second untuk chop garlic and onion sahaja. Okay, sekarang kita nak saute. So saute dalam Thermomix ni cuma mengambil masa dalam 3 hingga 5 minit saja. So now I'm going to add minyak masak kan. So sekarang ni kita kalau nak healthy kita bolehlah timbang minyak kita. Okay, kita letak weighing scale secara manual. Lepas tu saya nak letak dalam 40 hingga 50 gram ya, ikut resepi yang kita ada lah.
Ni resepi you ke? Resepi siapa?
Saya modify sebab nak bagi anak makan pizza supaya tak pedas. Kita ada banyaklah orang apa sifu-sifu dalam KLM dulu ya. Kita punya sini-sini dah buat banyak resepi. So kita sorti dulu ya. Nanti kita sambung cakap. So berapa minit kita nak sorti? I nak 3 minit sahaja. Ya Allah. Keluar pun mana ni. Okay. Okay. 3 minit sajalah. Okay, then untuk saute standard temperature 120. So kalau kita nak tumis ke apa ke, standard temperature 120 Celsius. And then speed dia saya letak 1. Okay. Menumis ataupun sorting dengan Thermomix ni, yang bagusnya dia tak lekat bau dekat baju. Yeah? So yang kita menumis atas stove biasa tu, dia punya fumes tu bersih apa? Mungkin nak cakap dia meresap terbang ke udara dan lekat ke baju, ke tudung semua. Jadi kita tak bolehlah pakai cantik-cantik. Kita kena pakai baju dapur dulu semua kan. Lepas tu nak jalan keluar ke apa, kena pakai baju lain sebab dia berbau baju kita. So dengan Thermomix yang keluar hanyalah aroma. Aroma kita menumis tu macam bau garlic dan onion tu. So the smell is still there, but it's not fumes. Yeah? It's aroma yang keluar. Okay tak? Faham tak?
Faham. Nampak.
Satu rumah kalau menumis tu apa akan jadi kat dapur kita selalu?
Jadi berasap tu satu. Lepas tu minyak tu merecik.
Sebab dia minyak terpercik kan? Dia bukan terpecik kat dinding stove saja tau. Dia kat lantai pun tau. Saya kalau kat kitchen tu kan menumis pakai kuali biasa sampai ni lah satu hole dapur ni kita pijak ada rasa lekit-lekit. Jadi
kabinet lepas pun.
Lepas masak tu kita kenalah mop lantai apa semua kan. Sebab apa, ialah banyak kerja lah. Tapi kalau menumis dalam ni, ialah ini kita promo-promo jugalah, tapi it's a fact. So lepas memasak, menumis, masak sambal ke apa, yang bestnya lepas masak semua clear, clean, tak ada terpercik, tak ada berkecah. Jadi nak mengemas lebih senang. Jadi untuk orang yang busy macam saya, lega banyaklah. Itu orang kata, alah masak kat dapur lagi best lah, baru dia cooking. Real tak real kan? Ha, real tak real. Yang penting kerja kita jadi senang. Buat apa kita nak jadi superwoman? Kalau kita dah tahu kita ni memang tak larat, letih, perlu bantuan. So this is the answer. Yeah? So kita bergantung kepada teknologi yang ada dan kemudahan yang ada. Why not? Yeah? Macam itulah lebih kurang pijak kenapa saya suka sangat dengan Thermomix ni. Masa, okay. Guys, okay. Sebelum tu, okay, sambil kita tumis ni, saya dah boleh mula rendam, ya. Sepatutnya saya pakai bihun jati yang saya biasa pakai, tapi jasmine pun saya pernah pakai. Okay, so kita nak rendam dulu, ya. Kau rendam di dalam plastik ni.
Saya suka teknik ini. Saya akan buat.
Ayalah kita punya fellow advisor share, Shasha ke siapa share. Okay, dia kata rendam je dalam plastik ni. Jadi tak payah banyak bekas nak pakai.
Betul lah.
Jai lah. Ini hack. Hack berlang ni.
Okay. Ini kita tutup. Sebab kan ada pembantu tepi ni, saya suruh dia pegang sekejap.
Brilliant. Right. Brilliant.
Ha, brilliant ya. Yeah? Okay, thank you so much.
Betul.
Okay, ni tengok ni. Cara nak buka cover lid ni, jangan sampai wap naik ke muka kita ya. Macam ni, macam shield. Okay, macam shield. Buka macam ni. So, wap tu pergi ke sana, halau dia ke sana. Okay, macam itulah. Alright. So, next step, I'm going to put water. Okay. Dia dah pegang macam ni. So formula untuk bihun goreng Thermomix ni, okay. Berat bihun campur dengan 150 air, dia jadi total water yang kita nak masuk. Okay, so saya 300 setengah campur 100 setengah. Tapi sebab saya ada masukkan extra sauce, maka saya nak masukkan apa ni je, 400 setengah. Sebab my 50 ml tu datang daripada I punya sauce liquid ya.
So dua benda lah Dr. Nora, while you are doing that kan, orang notice is satu, you baru nak start rendam bihun. Lepas tu nombor dua, serving size. Sebab nampak kita punya mixing bowl tu, mixing bowl tu nampak cenonek je. Mungkin you boleh tolong kita faham.
Mixing bowl ni nampak cenonek je kan. Walaupun nampak cenonek, tapi volume dia maksimum 2.2 liter. Lepas tu dia tinggi. So nampak cenonek tapi sebenarnya dia boleh dia satu paket bihun tu boleh masuk. So kita masak sentiasa fresh. Tak adalah dia malas, semua orang kata nak masak ramai-ramai macam mana. Masak ramai-ramai aku nak lah masak banyak kali. Takut tak susah pun kan.
Okay. Macam tadi so, bihun you tak rendam you tak rendam bihun, semalaman.
Bihun tadi tu masa kita start nak chopping, nak sorti tu baru kita rendam ya. So I masukkan all the sauce, so my total liquid become 400 setengah. Then masa ni terus kita masukkan sayur-sayur, sebab sayur yang saya suka pakai untuk bihun goreng is carrot dan juga kobis ya. So masukkan aja. Sebab dia nanti just nice, sebab dia keras. Dia keras kan, so kita boil dia sekali. So dalam menggoreng bihun dan Thermomix ni, kita bukan saja pakai function menumis, tapi kita actually guna kaedah boiling juga ya. So 5 minit kita boil 100 darjah Celsius untuk mendidih kan, untuk suhu didih. Dan sebabkan dia dah ada sayur-sayur kat dalam, saya letak spoon speed dan reverse supaya sayur tu tak adalah lerai ke putus ke pecah ke apa ya. So every time kita letak benda-benda macam yang kita tak nak hancur, kita pakai speed dia spoon and also reverse. So now kita ada 5 minit pijak untuk tunggu liquid ni boil atau didih sebelum kita masukkan bihun yang saya dah rendam tadi tu kan. Rendam dia macam just nice by the time. So bihun ni kira ni kita rendam dalam 5 hingga 7 minit macam itulah. Ikut jenis bihun juga tau. Kalau pakai jenis bihun A1 tu actually tak payah rendam pun tak apa. You rinse saja water dia sebab dia ikut jenis bihun. Ada yang jenis memang cepat lembut. So you kena tanya-tanyalah ataupun you kena try. Tapi dah kita dah bagi tahu ni some brand macam A1 tu tak payah rendam. Yang bihun jati, bihun jati, bihun jasmin kena rendam tapi sekejap saja. Bukan macam kaedah dulu-dulu kita kena rendam berjam-jam dulu kan sebab kita tak nak bihun kita keras kat dapur. Tapi teknik menggoreng bihun, dia suara pun tak keluar kan. Teknik menggoreng bihun dalam TM6 ni, dia pakai kaedah boiling campur. Okay. So nanti bila kita masukkan bihun dalam ni, kita tukar pula method dia jadi baroma. Baroma ni jadi
Dr. Nora, tweet-tweet. Tweet Dr. Nora, kesian you, I selamatkan suara you kejap sebab kita memang bagi you burn cuti sekejap 5 minit.
Okay.
So biar Dr. Nora boil dulu and kita akan
pergi kat
Dr.
Nora. Brain water bihun ni sekejap.
Yes. So kita akan, I akan pinjam spotlight. Hint-hint tu Aya. Okay. Sebab kita akan ada our first session about about more functionalities of the Thermomix itself. So korang memasak ni, makan ni, it's memories. So jomlah kita buat banyak-banyak makanan supaya we can make more memories. Alright, so tadi kita tengok Farah buat lemonade. You can make so many other things. Kopi boleh, boba boleh, oreng boleh. And then Cik Laila tunjuk macam nak buat roti, pizza, pasta. So imagine all of that, you can do it at home at any point of time yourself. And imagine you boleh buat ice cream juga. Dr. Nora nanti lepas dah buat bihun, dia nak tunjuk kita lagu mana nak buat ice cream. No preservative, and you can even buat with your kids. Isn't that nice? Isn't that beautiful? So a lot of people dalam chat tadi tanya about recipes. So we have a lot of recipes in our cooking class, in our Telegram support. Nanti kita tunjuk lah. Tapi kita akan terus pergi dekat quiz so that kita boleh reward kita punya guest untuk soalan yang you can get a present to. So I am going to ask Cik Aida to help me out with the quiz.
Okay.
A bit of the rules dulu lah Aida. You can go through the rules juga.
Okay, so kita go through rules kejap. So basically, you guys tak boleh jawab selagi I tak habis baca soalan tu. Tak acil lah kan, jawab terus. So I'm going to read the question. And then as soon as I finish the question, kita cepat-cepat type in. Type in your answer in the chat box. And the first person to get it correct will be the one to win the prize, okay? Tak nak lontarkan jawapan you in the voice, but you type in the answer. Okay, so ready everyone? Tangan dekat
keyboard. It's also for guests, our advisors, kita tolong monitor guests sahaja.
Advisor janganlah jawab. Advisor memang dah tahu. Okay, so I'm gonna ask the question. Tangan ready dekat your keypad ke apa? Alright, so the question is, kalau korang dengar betul-betul tadi, berapa minit kita gunakan kneading function untuk buat mantau tadi? Berapa minit kneading function tersebut?
Wow.
Sila jawab.
Laju.
Kau terus keluar jawapan.
2 minit, 2 minit, 3 minit, 2 minit, 2 minit. Lagi? Okay, Aida, kalau I tengok in my chat lah, kita ada Nur Shazni Khalid.
Yes, my chat pun sama, Nur Shazni Khalid.
Okay, I ke Aida ke yang I nak tanya other presenter, I ke Aida yang lag? Okay, Aida lag. Okay, tak apa. Bija take over sekejap. Boleh tak kita nak go to Nur Shazni Khalid? Boleh tak you go off mute? Hi. Hi, congratulations. You got it right. 2 minutes untuk knead your mantau. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Siapa
Thank
yang invite you to the show, Shazni?
One of my friend lah. She just ordered TM6 and she asked me to join this cooking show.
Great. Siapa kawan you?
Dr. Aino.
So I wonder who is Dr. Aino punya advisor. Do you know? Or if we have Dr. Aino punya advisor, you can also type it in the chat.
Okay.
Shazni, tak apa. Congratulations. We're going to figure out siapa yang invite you as in the advisor, because you win a token of appreciation for the quiz. Nah, boleh tak Fiza nak tanya, do you already have a Thermomix?
Not yet. I'm just surveying lah.
So macam kalau dekat rumah tu biasanya you masak untuk berapa orang?
I have 5 kids.
Wow.
And I'm everyday cook lah. Because I work from home, I'm a teacher. So I'm just survey lah this Thermomix.
Wonderful. So apa yang korang suka makan kat rumah, the kids especially?
Kita orang selalu order pizza, bihun. Setiap hari masak lah kiranya.
Eh, macam jodoh sangat lah. You masuk kita punya show hari ni, kita tengok bihun. So hopefully dapatlah tengok tips dari Dr. Nora macam mana nak buat bihun untuk family you lah, Syazni.
Ya, senang. Sangat senang. Ya.
Okay. Alright. Okay. Thank you so much, Syazni. Cikgu Syazni. For joining.
Thank you. Alright.
Thank you so much. Aida, sorry tadi you punya senyap lari sikit lah.
Kita okay, tahu. Okay. Thank you.
Kita tahu some of you might want to ask your partner first. Don't worry about it. Kita as advisor sangat memahami. We can help. Tapi tadilah apa yang Laila tunjuk kat kita tadi is something what we call Cookidoo. It's a subscription to our recipe platform. You can subscribe to over 70,000 recipes. And kalau tak nampak apa yang Laila tunjuk tadi, it's on the screen. And kita just click start cooking. Everything on the TM6 will be guiding you how to cook. Tadi ada orang tanya kan kalau buat kek, dia akan tulis tak? Yes, dia akan tulis. Just like this one, dia akan tulis how much weight, what to turn to. Everything is there. Tapi yang best about Cookidoo ni is a web application. Okay, it's web based. You just go to cookidoo.international and then macam you nak Google, tapi you search in Cookidoo, you letak aje resipi apa yang you nak, and then you can find so many recipes. Aida, up to now kita dah ada over 70,000 recipes. Berapa banyak you dah katam?
Wow, banyaknya. I rasa tak sampai 50 ke 100 kot.
Mungkin satu hari kita advisor kita buat competition lah berapa banyak kita boleh katam. But masa I join dulu Aida, kita ada 48,000, and today in July there's more than 70,000, meaning that it's a recipe library that grows. And kalau tengok kat sini it's about international recipes, but don't worry, kita ada masakan Nusantara. Check it out, we have Taste of Malaysia and even Let's Go Mamak. Jadi teh tarik, mi goreng mamak, ketayap, asam pedas, everything is in there as well. So you, macam nampak tadi Laila buat Cookidoo tu, kita tekan aja resipi ni and then dekat TM6 it will sync and you just ikut instruction, you click next. Advisor you boleh ajar you macam mana nak guna the guided cooking recipe kejap lagi ataupun when you get your Thermomix. And ada pelbagai jenis resipi lagi untuk anak-anak kita yang sedang membesar, daripada baby sampailah start makanan solid, and recipes for special occasion, diet, macam nak low fat ke, keto ke, birthday ideas, semua ada juga on your Thermomix recipe collection. Ini Aida paling sukalah. Dia suka buat meal planning. Aida is a planner. Tapi ke contoh ini I punya meal plan in November hari tu, bila I tak ada. You tengok ni, the whole week you can meal plan as far ahead as you want. And contoh, I tak ada barang-barang untuk buat ayam masak merah, I can generate a shopping list macam you tengok on the right here. And then I boleh show my ingredients and all my list is available, and I can hantar to my phone or to my husband, suruh dia yang pergi beli groceries dekat Jaya Jusco ke apa ke. Okay, it is very very convenient. It is what we call the future of cooking. And guess what, your Thermomix is ready because shipping has restarted for the stocks that are just here. So when you get your Thermomix, this is the entire package that you get. Yang Cookidoo you tengok I tunjuk tadi, you get it free for 6 months and you dapat a free physical cookbook some more. And guess what? Just for our show today, we have a pre-hosting gift. Okay, we have a pre-hosting gift, which is a rose gold bread pan. So for the first 8 orders that is placed today with the Cook and Share team, we are going to give you this pre-hosting gift from your advisor. Yeah, if you invite and refer 3 or 6 friends to come to the cooking show macam Dr. Syazni masuk tadi, then this is like macam pre-advance gift lah. Kita tahu that you are going to invite. So don't miss out this opportunity, because when you buy with Cook and Share, kita akan go through how to use the product, we do have cooking classes. Macam semua orang tanya resipi bihun tadi. We have all those recipes inside the Facebook group, our website, and dedicated group support. Selalu orang bertanya itu ini, how to do this, how to do that, recipe mana best. That's our dedicated support group. And when you purchase within July and August, you also get an extended 3 months warranty. Menarik sangat. Nobody, even not advisor, tak dapat this particular thing. So boleh tak Fiza nak minta tolong all of you yang on the fence, yang tapi dah maybe jump over the fence, not your Thermomix, to write in the chat, I want TM6-advisor name, macam Laila ke, Nora ke, Aida ke, because kita nak book your rose gold bread pan for you. Definitely. Yang tu memang kita pentingkan lah. Kita nak make sure that you dapat. So please put down in the chat, I nak TM6 and your advisor name. So jangan malu and jangan segan. Throughout the show pun you nak tulis, you can. Because Tini and myself, we're going to extract it and we're going to make sure you get it. So we're going to continue cooking. Kita akan berbalik kepada Nora sebab dia nak tunjuk macam mana nak letak bihun. Ha, dah siap dah sebenarnya bihun dia. Tinggal nak goreng je.
Ha, dengar kan? Baru nak unmute. Okay. Okay, sekarang dia punya liquid dah boil. Okay. Right. So kita masukkan je bihun yang dah siap drain tadi ya. Kita masukkan saja. Masukkan bihun. Ha, nampak satu paket kan? Ha, penuh sampai ke atas ni. Okay. Tapi masih lagi ada ruang sebab kita dah buat the recipe supaya the volume tak exceed from the maximum volume. So apa saya nak letak lepas ni is the untuk bihun goreng ni saya letak udang dan sotong saja ya. Jadi saya letak hujung-hujung ni lah sebab udang dengan sotong ataupun siput dia cepat masak. Okay, so tak boleh letak awal, nanti sotong dia kecil tak sedap. Okay, the next step lepas dah masuk bihun dengan haiwan-haiwan, okay. Kita pakai mode yang lain pula. Tadi apa? Chopping, lepas tu sorting, lepas tu boiling. Now kita pakai varoma. Varoma tu apa? Varoma tu temperature untuk steaming sebenarnya, tapi dia juga boleh digunakan untuk memekatkan kuah. So remember tadi kita ada liquid dalam ni about 450 kan? Ha, jadi kita letak varoma, so at the same time dia boiling together with the thicken the liquid. Okay, so kita letak reverse and spoon speed. Yeah. So give me 4 minutes and plus few more minutes to let the bihun sit in the hot water. So that the bihun dia akan naturally kembang while absorbing the hot water. Nanti kita tengok outcome dia. Alright.
Thank you Dr. Nora. Nanti sekarang kita nak suruh you serve. You kalau dia dah ready, you boleh serve separuh. Tapi kita nak tengok you tuang lah. Alright. So kita sekarang akan ke Laila balik. I'm sure ramai dah rindu Laila dengan kitchen dia yang macam studio tu. Laila, I rasa you tengah siapkan your butter chicken. Yes, and by the way, sorry kejap. I tengok ada ramai orang dah tulis I want TM6. Dah 5 yes. orang. So I'm gonna take note.
Yay,
of
more,
Alhamdulillah,
more.
Ruzi, Syafiqah, Nadia, siapa lagi? Haliza, Shika. And tadi I ada nampak Kak Fiza punya, Syafiqah juga. Okay, go ahead Laila. I nak take down note sekarang.
Okay, so I've already started with some of the steps for my butter chicken. Just to let you know, butter chicken ni I ikut recipe from this cookbook from Anis Nabila. Okay, so not only you get recipes from Cookidoo yang macam I tunjuk tadi, you can get it from cookbooks, cookbooks as well as macam being in the cook and share community. So macam Dr. Nora tadi share her own bihun recipe. So being in the community pun there's a lot of recipes that you can get as well. So here, I dah tumis, I dah letak perencah semua, I dah tumis that as well. I tengah tunggu selepas when my mantau dah ready, nanti I will show how I stack them up. Okay, so ni, butter chicken ni sedap sangat. So, it's one of our family's favorite because bila you makan tu, you rasa macam, wow, you makan kat a fancy Indian restaurant lah. Memang the taste is really authentic. Okay, this is done. Let me just switch that off. And imagine kalau butter chicken you makan, you beli kat restaurant, I think apa satu mangkuk je pun dah macam RM20 or one off. You'll see the portion that I'm making banyak sangat. So your whole family is able to enjoy it at safely at home, insyaAllah. Yeah, okay. Pija, do you want me to stack it now ke nanti?
Pija, where's Pija?
Sorry, I mute. Yang tu you dah letak tomatoes and cream everything, is it?
Yes, I have.
Yeah. Boleh tak you tolong buka sekejap? Buka the lid and tunjuk okay what's inside.
Oh, tengok tu. The smell macam, wow, I memang dekat restoran mana lah.
Okay, so sekarang dia seorang tengah shock. Kita nak bagi shock semua orang shock. Nampak sikit lagi, sikit lagi, sikit. Perfect. Okay. Yang tu belum letak. Okay. Itu belum letak air tak?
Ayah belum. Belum awal faham.
You punya buns dah naik ke?
Dah, tapi naman. Go ahead first. Nanti kita, nanti come back to me kot.
Okay, nanti. Actually, we can stack it if you want. Yeah, let's stack it.
Okay, okay. Alright, give me a second to take it out. Sebab I letak my buns dalam tempat nak oven lah. Tapi tak on pun. Yeah. Okay.
Aida, how about you? You kalau memasak, you pernah tak buat butter chicken ni?
Oh yes, I pernah. I pernah, cuma I just kurangkan dia punya keperasan because I can't take spicy food. But yes, I pernah try and I pernah stack it up together with mantau. Memang macam makan kat dulu kat TTDI ada kedai Indian restaurant nama Namaste.
Sama. Yelah, kedai tu dah tutup dah. Okay, Laila.
Yeah, alah, sedihnya. Tak apa,
yeah, butter diri. Yes, exactly. Butter chicken ni versatile sangat. So, you boleh makan dengan cicah dengan pau. Okay, sekejap. Let me show you. You boleh buat dengan naan. Okay, ni dah gebu-gebu.
Very nice.
Wow.
You duk risau. So, you tak boleh nak shape cantik-cantik lah. Wah, dia tengok. Okay, let's.
Bawah ni pun ada, okay? Cuma-cuma main lihat. Okay. What I'm going to do is multi-layer cooking. So, as I am... Sekejap, I nak ambil ayam
Baru nak tanya, ayam dah masuk ke?
Tadi tu Pija, banyak sangat orang cakap nak ni. Macam mana ni Pija?
I pun tak sempat. Jadi Aida, you kena tolong layan Laila. Sementara I ambil nama diorang.
Ya. Kita kena check ni dengan branch manager kita. Okey ke tak ni?
Branch manager ada tak? Branch manager ada. I tahu dia rajin tengok kita buat show.
Boleh. Ya Allah, kalau ada 10 pun kita bagi juga.
Okay, I kira bos. Thank you. Jadi terus letakkan. Eh, ni bukan saja-saja. Memang normally we just offer 5. We normally offer 5. But today, we put extra lah. I tengoklah berapa ramai kita ada. Okay, what you doing now, Laila?
Okay, I dah buka the small lid atas tu. So there is a small lubang that the steam will come through and masuk to your steaming tray. So now I'm just setting the time to 10 minutes. Lebih dah pula. Okay. And then I set temperature to varoma. So similar macam. That's why the varoma tu nanti the wok tu akan help steam your buns. Okay. So jangan lupa letak. Almost lupa. Letak reverse blade. And then just put it to spoon. So dia macam kacau for you. At the same time nanti dia akan create wok. And steam your bun. So multi-layer cooking ni macam-macam you boleh buat. You boleh buat nasi ayam. You boleh masak masak soup kat dalam ni together with your nasi. And atas you can steam your chicken, sayur. Lagi apa lagi? Masak nasi kat sini. Boleh buat lauk macam steam ikan, steam ayam. So steaming ni is obviously a healthier way of eating lah kan. So because it retains the nutrients and all the good stuff in your food. Maybe Aida and Pijan nak share apa lagi, apa korang pernah buat lagi dengan multi-layer ni?
Yeah, usually memang it's nasi, protein and sayur. Otherwise,
so you,
tapi people may wonder, nasi tu letak kat mana Laila?
Itu dalam ni, dalam simmering basket yang macam tadi Farah, yang macam Farah guna tadi, you put it inside here. So masak nasi is also a healthier way if you masak dalam simmering basket tu. Sebab the starch nanti, water and starch tu akan turun ke bawah. Yeah.
Wah, ada orang kata boleh sanitize botol baby. Betul, that's so correct. Boleh boleh sterilize jars juga at the same time. So those are the things lah that you can do.
Alrighty.
Memang, yeah, macam-macam.
So kalau kita tengok Laila, dia dengan sweetnya just duduk dekat situ, tak 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 stir pun in her very
pakai
nice
baju putih
weekend.
Tu bijak.
Baju putih, tudung putih,
yeah, dengan kari-kari.
So nanti kadang kita akan tengok Laila plating lah at the end and berapa banyak butter chicken untuk kita enjoy as a family. So for now kita akan ke kita ke Farah ke kita pergi dekat Dr. Nora ni. Dr.
Okay,
Nora.
Dah siap. I dah siap nak tunjuk bihun keluar dari blender boleh?
Ah boleh, jom. Dia nak keluar lagu mana?
Okay, start lah. Ni tu dia sebab tak puas sebab dia nak bagi hampa tengok aku punya Thermomix ni kan. So, I kena dari belakang. Okay. Okay, kita buka dia. Okay. Lindia, tengok.
Tu dia.
Penuh kan? Ni boleh makan kalau family saya ada berapa orang? 5, 6, 7 orang. Ya? Yeah? So, macam mana kita nak bawa keluar bihun goreng ni? Ni bihun goreng tak pedas sangat lah sebab tak pakai cili api apa semua kan, just chili sauce.
Dr. Nora, kebelakangkan sikit.
Kebelakangkan
server. Okay, nampak tak? Kesian you jauh you.
Kurang lah, sat. Okay, kita pegang lagu ni. Kita pegang lagu ni eh.
Okay, boleh.
Oh,
pojok makau. Pojok, ha, dia loncat. Aku kata dah, dia nak loncat.
Ah, tengok. Bukannya. Tak ada rahsia lah. Okay, semua masak elok. Apa nama? Wah,
tak berperak.
Ya, ya. Sat lagi hujung rancangan. Kita plating bagi lawa. Untuk sementara ni nak tunjuk sajalah. Dia sotong ada, udang ada, cabbage ada. Ya. So, itulah kadang-kadang orang kata apa dia masak bihun goreng pakai blender. Tapi hampa kena try. Kalau sekarang tak ada pandemik COVID kan, buat demo face to face, kena rasa memang sedap. Bukan
tak
nak
putus,
no? Bukan, ha, bukan nak bayar sebab kata Thermomix ni bagus ke apa, tapi rasa dia sedap. Ni tanyalah saya punya kawan-kawan yang pernah attend demo apa semua tu, dia pun memang cakap bihun goreng Thermomix sedap, ya. So kalau siapa yang bakal ataupun akan menjadi user Thermomix, mesti kena try resepi ni lah.
Boleh. Hmm. Keluar lo, habis keluar lorak dia.
Alia habis. Baru syok cakap, baru kuat. Suara keluar kan?
Okay, so Nora juga akan menggunakan bowl yang sama untuk buat ais krim dia. Jadi, Nora, you
so
akan...
So, need time to wash. So, nanti...
Are you going to pre-clean?
Are you going to pre-clean?
Yes. Nak tunjuk sekarang kah?
Boleh?
Nak tunjuk, okay. Kena
mengalir. Okay, tak apa, tak apa. Kita pergi dekat... kita pergi terus kat Farah. Nanti Farah, Laila, you akan pre-clean, okay? Alright. Farah, kita merindui you. Kita nak timing juga ke?
Boleh lah. Okay. My second dish I nak masak, okay, stir fry broccoli and carrots. Okay, I nak tanya, siapa yang kat sini selalu masak sayur tapi anak tak nak makan? Cuba letak kat komen. Struggle nak bagi anak makan sayur. Bukan
Kasmira, Nuraida.
Saya bukan struggle nak bagi anak je. Suami pun tak nak makan sayur sebenarnya.
Yusnaili, ramailah juga yang menjawab kata dia orang pun struggle okay. Sikit.
Saya kan masa okay, yang saya beli Thermomix ni dekat Dr. Nora. Waktu mula-mula tu kan macam kita jual mahal sikit, alah ni pun boleh buat ni. Tapi kan bila Dr. Nora demo sayur brokoli ni, ya Allah, memang lain betul rasa dia. Okay, mari saya tunjuk eh. Okay, ni saya akan masukkan as we go along. Saya akan bagi tahu eh. Okay, saya akan masukkan garlic saja. Garlic. Kita akan chop untuk 5 seconds, speed 5.
Garlic tak kupas ke tu?
Ada.
Okay. Masuk tak kupas tu. Tak nampak sangat tadi lah. Tak apa, mesti dia tunjuk kulit.
Sorry. I punya air tambik yang dah kupas.
Tak apa.
Actually kita... actually dia boleh tak kupas juga sebab ini sangat bagus tau, especially untuk orang yang sensitif. Tangan dia sensitif, ada setengah orang dia sensitif dekat cili, ada setengah orang dia sensitif dekat garlic, ada setengah orang dia sensitif dekat macam sabun cuci pinggan kan. So yang ni kita memang tak touch langsung. Nak kena take, tunjuk ke balik pija?
Tunjuk sikit lah.
Okay.
Sikit je.
Okay. Tengok 5 second.
Dua biji.
Oh, nak tunjuk balik. Okay.
Tak apa.
Ada. I ambil.
Tak. Nak habang. Dua biji je. Tapi still boleh blend. Still boleh chop.
Okay. Okay. So, kita tengok next. Okay. Ni I guna olive oil. 10 gram. Untuk tumis eh. Okay. Selalu kan kita selalu dengar kan orang cakap kalau olive oil ni dia guna untuk apa? Untuk buat dressing saja. Dia tak boleh guna untuk macam tumis-tumis macam ni. Sebab apa tau? Orang selalu cakap macam tu. Sebab olive oil ni dia punya smoke point ni dia kalau tak salah I 160 darjah Celsius. So kalau okay I tumis ni 120 saja. 120 darjah Celsius saja. Kalau kita tumis kat stove, kita tak boleh control sebab siapa masak sambil pegang termometer kan, sekejap-sekejap tembak kan, betul tak?
Macam nak masuk kedai pula sekarang.
Yes, betul. Sekarang kita tembak kuali kita kan, tak. So kan kita tak boleh control, tapi dengan Thermomix dari mula sampai habis memang 120 ni je. Dia tak akan pergi sekejap 180, sekejap 130. Ini tak dapat achieve kalau kita masak dengan stove. Sebab apa lagi satu, sebab apa kita guna low temperature. Dia kan bila kita guna low temperature, it just enough to release dia punya flavor. Okay, sebab kalau lebih pada tu, dia akan membuatkan makanan kita akan rasa burn. Sebab itulah anak-anak kita tak suka makan sayur sebab bila rasa burn, dia macam rasa pahit sikit. Budak-budak kan tak suka rasa pahit-pahit tu. Tapi bila dengan Thermomix, kita masak dalam controlled temperature, dia macam release sweet. Sayur tu akan rasa manis, dia retain color. So budak-budak tengok, menarik, sedap. I kan sejak ada Thermomix, I tak pernah masak sayur guna dulu kan nak bagi budak-budak suka, siap guna secukup rasa lah, sos tiram lah. Tapi untuk lepas dah ada Thermomix, just guna garam, garlic dengan olive oil. Itu je. Tapi budak-budak memang suka. Nanti I panggil anak I tau. So dia rasa. Sebab budak-budak tak pandai tipu tau.
Betul.
Tadi kita dapat tengok kan, anak pija pun suka.
Apa lagi kalau sayur lain you cuba masak kat situ?
I suka masak lagi satu kobis. Kobis, lepas tu kangkung goreng belacan sedap, bendi, sayur bendi macam-macam. I selalu try cauliflower.
Ni masakan harian ni kan ni. Kita tak payah masak benda gempak-gempak pun tak.
Ya, betul-betul. Sebab I selalu cakap kat my husband. I cakap kan I memang nak anak-anak I makan sayur. Sebab apa sekarang kan you tahu kan macam zaman pandemik ni I avoid untuk diorang. Macam harap-harap tak, diorang tak sakit lah. Sebab bila sakit nak kena pergi apa? Nak kena pergi.
Farah, just like you know your video hilang, Zat.
Oh, sekejap.
Terkatup sikit. Dah. Ada balik.
Okay. I cakap kat my husband. Dia cakap, sebab kan untuk bina antibody yang kuat, you kena apa makan benda yang healthy kan.
Hilang lagi. Hilang.
Sekejap, eh. Apa hilang?
Ada orang tekan. Dah.
Okay. Ni. Next. Okay. Ni I dah masuk potong siap-siap. Masukkan brokoli.
Tinggal satu lah.
Tinggal satu. Okay. Masuk brokoli. Then masuk carrot. I dah masuk sekali. Lepas tu masuk salt.
Ni tak payah edit perisa ke? You just
tak payah. Secukup rasa ke, sos tiram ke, tak payah. Lepas tu lagi satu, kalau kita masak biasa kan, you perasan tak kita akan masak carrot dulu sebab kononnya carrot tu keras kan? Betul tak?
Betul.
Kita akan masak carrot dulu, lepas tu dah carrot tu layu sikit, lepas tu kita baru masak sayur-sayur lain. Ni I masak je semua sekali, 4 minit je.
Ni Ayu ada cakap dia suka masak. Dia suka makan kangkung goreng belacan tapi tak suka masak sebab kalau tidak bau satu rumah.
Okay. Sebab guna Thermomix kan tertutup ni, lagi saya tak bau. Memang sebab dia yang jadi bau tu sebab bila kita pakai high temperature dia akan create fume. Fume tu yang akan macam, cuba tengok kita orang pakai kan, semua pakai putih cantik-cantik demo masak kan.
Thank you. Thank you Farah. So kita ni step terakhir Farah masak untuk hari ni. Lepas tu dia pun pakai cookie dough macam Laila tadi. So kejap lagi kita akan kembali dekat Farah bila dia reveal. So kita nak pergi dekat Dr. Nora untuk tunjuk last sekali. Kita nak buat aiskrim pakai bowl yang dia guna untuk masak bihun tadi. Cuma I tak nampak Dr. Nora dekat dalam screen right now. Jadi tak apa. Just to let everybody know lah. Aida, nanti you hint dekat I bila Dr. Nora dah masuk. Tadi okay. I dok collect-collect. Did you know that more than 7,000 families dah order a Thermomix in June and July? So kita selalu tanya, what do you want to eat first? What do you want to cook first? Okay, those kind of things. Selalu kita tanya as advisor. And tadi I collected 9 names. 9 names yang kata they want to get their Thermomix now. So cuba korang tengok ada tak nama you dekat sini. I think I ada seorang tadi. I think it's Dr. Shazni. Cikgu Shazni tadi kot. Nanti saya letak nama you. But ada tak nama korang kat sini? And advisors, take note. Sebab these are your customers who would like for you to help them with their Thermomix. So Dr. Nora is back.
Yep, yep.
Or okay, no? Coming.
Hampir mana?
Pilah, pre-clean lah, nak cuci lah. Ni nak buat aiskrim ni. Kena bagi kering. Kena bagi kering dulu lah bowl dia. Okay. So, okay. So, bowl bekas bihun. Tak ada lah bau teruk sangat kan. Sebab dia stainless steel. Stainless steel ni, dia tak melekat bau. Ya, yeah? So, kalau kita nak masak benda savoury ke, lepas tu nak buat benda yang sweet, lepas tu dessert, tak ada masalah. Boleh pakai same bowl kalau kita ada satu bowl saja. Lagi bagus kalau kita ada dua bowl. Macam mana tak dapat dua bowl? Belilah dua biji itu. So tanpa melengahkan masa ya. So next, boleh start dekat pinjam?
Sila, sila please.
Okay. Alright. So next menu kita adalah aiskrim buah-buahan. Okay. Saya ada kat saya ni.
Tak nampak Nora punya screen Nora.
Angkat Thermomix. Angkat Thermomix pergi belakang.
Oh, Thermomix
lah.
Thermomix tak nampak dah. Tu dia.
Okay.
Right. So kita ada kita kena ada okay, buah-buahan yang kita nak buat aiskrim ya. Yeah? So saya ada kat sini buah dragon fruit yang warna shocking pink. So kita cut in cubes. Nah, dengar tak? Kita cut in cubes. Okay, and kita simpan macam ni dalam freezer, okay? Supaya senang dia nak dicerai-ceraikan sebelum kita buat ice cream. Lagi satu buah yang kita pakai untuk bagi the creamy effect adalah jeng-jeng-jeng, banana, ya? Eh?
Banana.
Pisang yang manis tu lagi afdol, ya?
Afdol? Kita ikut cakap doktor.
Okay. Okay, so ini pun menu manual. So tadi Farah pun ada pakai mode yang sama iaitu apa? Mode turbo ya sebab kita nak blend kiranya macam ais lah ni sebab dia kan walaupun buah tapi kita frozen dia jadi macam ice cube juga nah. So kita masukkan semua. So saya dah timbang ni dalam 200 gram banana. Ya kita boleh juga pakai pineapple ya kalau nak untuk bagi macam tekstur dia tu dan dia rasa masam-masam sikit pun nice juga. So cut the banana jadi half ya. So masukkan pineapple tapi saya nak pakai semua banana. And then 300 gram dragon fruit yang warna shocking pink ya. Okay so ini ais krim ni sihat ke tidak? Okay kita tubuh dulu.
Sihat lah.
Kita cakap pasal apa itu sihat lah.
Baiklah. Sambil
so, turbo maksimum 2 saat saja. So kita buat 2 kali dulu. Okay. Kita repeat turbo 2 kali. Tengok dia punya bunyi dah macam perlahan sikit. Maknanya kata dia dah mula jadi serpihan kecil ya. Nak tengok kah ke tak yang?
Nak
tengok? Okay. Ini dia nak tunjukkan Aida. Ni baru turbo lah.
Semua orang tengok eh.
Lepas turbo, ni lepas ni terus boleh makan ni, ni aiskrim sihat kita hari ni. So letak berapa saat? Kita letak dalam 30 saat ya.
Wow, sekejap je 30 je.
Sekejap tak sampai 1 minit pun siap dah aiskrim boleh panggil. Mai, mai makan aiskrim kan? Okay, kita letak speed 6 ya. So saya naikkan slowly. Ada speed 3.
Wah, kita dengar. Selain daripada aiskrim apa yang korang nak cuba buat? Cuba tulis kat dalam chat aiskrim apa yang korang minat. Coklat ke? Banana ke? Wush, siap keluar dia punya bekas nak.
Wah, wow, bekas bermain-main. Kalau-kalau
durian. Syazwana nak durian. Lagi? Aida, you nak apa? Coklat?
I nak buat mango. I suka mango.
Eh, siap dah pizza.
Oh, siap dah. Ah, next time kan kita punya show kita kena buat aiskrim durian lah. Ramai orang minta durian.
Oh ya ke? Kan. Nak stok durian hari
itu
ni.
Itu Kak Jam, Kak Jam, Kak Jam.
Ah, Kak Jam. Okey, okey, dusun durian. Okey. Okey, tara.
Wow. Cantik tool tu.
So nombor yang pertama, tak ada tambahan color yang fake ya. Bukan color tiruan ni, color asli. Yang kedua, tak ada tambahan gula ya. Dia harapkan manis buah dia saja. Okey. Yang ketiga, tak ada preservatif. Ha, faham ke tak faham anak murid bila kata maksud kata aiskrim ni sihatlah. Saya memanglah saya doktor kan. Ha, tapi orang lain pun kena tahulah juga kan. Jadi kita tak ada added sugar. So just all natural flavor, natural sweetness ya. Jangan tambah gula dah. Banana yang kita pakai tu kalau jadi manis dia memang dah ada natural sugar dia. Dan juga dragon fruit kita.
Okay. Kita semanis senyuman you.
Ya, semanis manisnya.
Handsome. Kak Fiza kata juga. Handsome aiskrim tu. Sega. Sega eh. Ada orang tanya
suka,
ni. Ikuan, Ikuan.
Suka kata sega.
Ikuan tanya boleh tak? Tiga kali aku dah cuba ni. Tiga kali Ikuan tanya. Ikuan tanya, boleh ke kita buat McD Sunday punya cone aiskrim tu?
Ada menu dia dalam Kukidu tapi dia bukan jenis yang macam ni lah. Mana kata ada setengah tu dia kena masuk dalam freezer balik untuk jadikan aiskrim. So ada menu aiskrim yang lain. Yang ini fruit aiskrim yang fresh. Yang terus boleh makan. Tapi kalau tak habis makan, boleh simpan dalam freezer. Okay, siap dah?
Siap dah. Tergugat aku. Tak nak jadi host dah, next time. Boy. Tak nak. Tak nak jadi host.
Rasa nak? Rasa lah nak?
Sip-sip bukan puasa.
Kan? Ha, ada orang puasa. Okay.
No
okay, best
lah.
Best
sangat ni. Aduh, nak kena buat apa ni?
Korang suka tak? Kalau korang suka apa yang Dr. Nora share campur dengan dia punya ilmu-ilmu tu, korang tulis ice cream. Dia zoom lagi tak senang tu doktor. Thank you Dr. Nora. Okay, so kita belum nak reveal fully lagi. Jadi doktor, you simpan kejap dalam tea sejuk. Kita nak pergi sekejap dekat Laila. Laila dah tuang. Dah siap sebenarnya. Tapi Laila, you nak tunjuk pre-clean set, nah?
Yep. Okay. Just want to show you the portion that I got from my butter chicken. Tengok sampai tak muat bekas. Macam bekas ada.
Okay. Macam okay, boleh so masuk this... satu baldi.
Yeah. Makan beramai-ramai, cicah dengan pau. Okay, that's how the bowl looks like after I dah masak butter chicken. So now I'm just going to pour in some water. So dengan minyak-minyak ni semua tak payah, dah tak payahlah you nak apa? Letak air panas lah, nak wait for it to keluar lah apa. And I'm just putting in some water. I'll put it up into, as long as it covers the blade or right at 1 liter mark. Okay, thanks. So by the time nak makan pun food dah ready and then you boleh je pre-clean. Okay. So now I tengah nak cari pre-clean mode. I tekan pre-clean. And then here, ada 4 different settings for pre-clean, for dough. So macam tadi kalau I buat mantau buns tu, after that pre-clean, I boleh guna dough. Universal, fat or caramel and browning. So I'm just going to use universal lah. Okay, so It will take approximately 8 minutes. 8 minutes nak basuh tu agak lama lah. Tapi when you buy Thermomix, you are buying time. In this 8 minutes, you dah boleh makan dah sebenarnya. Tapi 8 minutes habis makan tu tak tahulah. So, then you just leave it lah.
Very nice. Thank you so much, Laila. Okay, so I think we are just waiting for all the presenters to sort of plate, and we will go back to them in a while. So last but not the least, when you purchase a Thermomix with Cook and Share, we also have the free classes that we do on a weekly or bi-weekly basis. So macam hari besok itself pukul 10 pagi, pukul 10.30 pagi, kita ada kelas nak masak tahu berlauk dan juga pie. Pai cantik dari Shasha. So you guys got to check it out. And you also get a Raya ebook and recipe cards for free. Free sahaja. Download lah. You boleh masak lah sepenuh sepuas hati you. And then when kita dah tak ada MCO nanti, kita ada physical classes dengan a real chef, a professional chef, because sekarang ni kita semua chef lah, okay, tapi this one professional chef from France, ajar macam mana nak buat pasta, different kind of dessert. So these are the things that we offer from Cook and Share. And we also have contests, love your Thermomix, you win a bun pan, so you don't want to miss out in the Cook and Share community activities. And when you purchase a Thermomix, you bukan dapat sahaja benda-benda yang kita tengok Laila, Nora and Farah masak, you get a ceret. Tapi ceret ni menarik, dia bukan 100 degree Celsius sahaja. Siapa yang ada babies tu kan, this would be so perfect for you untuk panaskan air for your susu. Susu baby you. So don't miss out. And for your coffee, for your matcha tea. So it is also your ceret. And it is also your slow cooking device. You boleh masak lamb stew, sup tulang, red bean soup, macam-macam with the slow cooking mode. And it can even go up to 8 jam when you are making slow cooked food. So you don't have to worry. It can last that long cooking your amazing dishes. And siapa minat, you can make your own cheese and yogurt. Tadi Alia nampak I makan yogurt sambil bercerita. I memang buat this yogurt from my Thermomix, my blueberry yogurt. And this week I nak cuba buat yogurt using soya milk pula. I do all those recipes and I use the fermentation mode. Siapa minat buat your own cheese for your palak panir, this is, there are lots of recipes that you can try using the fermentation mode. And yang ni I rasa Aida sukalah, makan with your protein, your salmon, your steak. You use the sous vide method whereby you rendamkan your protein inside a water bath. And this is a method, a very technical method. With Thermomix, it can hold the temperature precise to 1 degree, which is what is required of the sous vide method. And you can even masak up to 12 jam. Siapa yang familiar with this, memang you will love this. You don't have to buy another sous vide machine. How much is the sous vide machine, Aida?
Dalam 3,000 plus juga, and the size is so big, susah nak simpan.
Kan, dia dalam basin kan? You have like to use like a basin for that. So don't miss out. It's, your Thermomix becomes your sous vide machine juga. So we saw quite a lot of benefits that you can get from the Thermomix. You hari-hari you boleh buat lemonade tu supaya perut tak boncik kan. Parah kan? So it's very quick and easy. Everybody now can cook. So I tengok orang nak buat your pizza, your roti. Everybody can utilize the Cookidoo and the support of the community to make all your desired food. It is very healthy. Tengok makan broccoli sekejap lagi. And even the ice cream yang no preservative. And then everybody just now masak, diorang tak duduk tepi dapur. They can actually go run about, sidai kain ke, go into a meeting ke, do a cooking show ke apa ke, because it auto cooks and auto wash for you. And perasan semua orang suka Laila punya kitchen because the Thermomix is going to save a lot of space on your countertop and even in your storage cabinet. And we say goodbye to cooking fumes yang gambar paling last kali ni sebab you notice tak ada hood. Everybody yang masak tadi tak ada hood untuk tarik the cooking fumes ataupun apa orang Melayu panggil, Aida? Aida?
Aruk bukan.
Hampa gas? Tak tahu.
I feel sikit.
Ya. Asap-asap yang keluar daripada
delaga.
Delaga. Okey. Tak ada lah kot tu. Asap lah, tak ada asap eh. Okey. Teruk tu kita ni. So there's a lot of benefits and paling best is honestly, I enjoy the community. I can't wait for you to be part of the community. I tengok Adila baru letak I want a TM6. Definitely your name's going to be there. And everybody now can own a Thermomix when you... tadi I tunjuk 7188. But tengok tu, ada slash. It's actually 6988 for a while already. When you do full settlement, you will get a free gift from Thermomix Malaysia. And you can even do financing 0% interest up to 24 months. So imagine that this is the best investment that you're going to make untuk family you. Macam bila you beli Thermomix, you ada dekat rumah tu, you akan memasak untuk semua orang dekat rumah. And paling syok bila husband I, Mus, yang tolong masak, dia tengok Aida sendu kat rumah ke, tiba-tiba je satu hari tu kan Aida dah siap lamb kima dengan roti. Roti.
Weh, lamb kima tu bukan
lamb senang. Lamb kima tu bukan senang. So macam terharu, sayang lebih kat dia. Tapi I sayang Thermomix jugalah. Okay, so everybody insyaAllah can own your Thermomix today. And when you own your Thermomix, when you purchase and you ajak kawan you to watch a cooking show, either personally or with this kind of cooking show that we do as a brunch, you akan dapat free gift. Eh, tapi lupa. Sekarang ni, kalau korang order within July and August, company akan give you 3 months extended warranty. Normally, 2 tahun je, but you akan dapat extra 3 months. Berapa ringgit ni, Aida? So definitely don't want to miss this. And then tadi I cakap you akan dapat free gift. You tengok ni, you akan dapat muffin mold, you akan dapat steaming trays, you akan dapat a free cookbook. Ada 4 hadiah. Tak pernah-pernah company kasi 4 hadiah. Normally 1, maximum 2, and this time ada 4. So you definitely want to order. And tadi I dah cakap if you make full payment, you boleh dah pilih one of these cookbook, Malay Kitchen ataupun Chinese Flavor. Satu cookbook ni RM160 tau. So you definitely want to grab this offer. And ada tulis kat sini, if you order sebelum 1 Ogos, which is besok, you akan dapat your Thermomix by end of August. Kita ship Thermomix according to order date. Siapa order awal, dia akan dapat dulu. Okay, so that kita adil dan saksama for everybody. So make sure that you place your order very, very quickly so that company boleh send it directly to you. So I nak you all tulis balik semula. Siapa yang belum tulis tadi, I want TM6-advisor name, because you are going to get the pre-hosting gift from your advisor. So please make sure you want, you grab the rose gold bread penny very, very quickly. And please, please try to submit your orders today. So own a Thermomix. Ni your advisor akan tunjuk you the payment schedule. It is, you can get it as low as RM2 per month pakai installment option. And we also accept debit card. Ramai orang kita tak ada debit card, but now the option is there. Jadi jangan lepaskan peluang ni, kawan-kawan. And if you nak Thermomix but you tengok bank you tak ada dekat sini, tak apa, your advisor can advise further. Contoh macam kalau Bank Islam tak ada, BSN tak ada, tapi you nak full installment, don't worry, you tanya you punya advisor and they will always, they can consult the team managers and branch manager, and we will try to help you. So tadi ada sikit je package, tapi tengok ni, I ada animation nak tunjuk semula. Pah! When you get your Thermomix, you dapat free Cookidoo subscription untuk 6 bulan and also the basic cookbook. But free lagi, I tunjuk lagi sekali animation, cooking classes, especially tomorrow, please start and join. Free delivery, Farah selalu kata kita belanja delivery. Yeah, the recipes yang orang selalu risau ada tak cukup and everything. Not just you have Cookidoo, but you also have online recipe community. It's free for you to join and you can even upload your recipes kasi orang lain tengok. Tapi once you get your Thermomix, kita as advisor akan unbox. Kita akan ajar you macam mana nak guna the Thermomix supaya you boleh pakai on the get-go. And the advisor is going to be there for your personal support. Exclusive 3 first month tu, you nak call, you nak message ke, memang advisors cook and share should be there. And 2 years warranty. 2 years warranty, but now it's actually added 3 more months. So please, please do not miss out this opportunity. I dok tengok a few more names came up. I yes. Nampak ya. Adila, Aida,
Nawar tu.
Nawar. And how much is the renewal fee for Cookidoo? Sharin bertanya. So, tadi kalau kita tengok this picture kan, kalau satu cookbook ni harga dia RM160, lebih kurang 60-70 recipes. Tapi dalam Cookidoo, 70,000 plus. Tapi dalam satu tahun you bayar $39. So sekarang ni with exchange rate agak-agak RM160 untuk the whole year. Alright, so that is the renewal fee. So please do not miss out. After this show, your advisors akan give you a call to help you with any more questions, tips kalau nak pujuk husband, nak pujuk wife. Ada ya, wife yang tak nak Thermomix ni. Jadi kita boleh tolong kat segitu juga. And if you are interested to be part of the advisor in Cook and Share, diorang pun boleh jawab that soalan itself. So now it's actually reveal time. And kita akan first go to Farah because kita rindu Farah lebih.
Hi, okay. So, I akan buat close up sikit ni.
Boleh.
Tengok I punya ni. Oops. Okay, tu. Tengok dia punya color tu. Okay, I tunjuk. Ini yang I keluarkan tak masak tu. Yang belum masak. Cuba tengok color dia.
Nice.
Ha, kan cantik. Okay, lagi satu yang paling penting. Elina. Kan? Ha, saya cakap tadi, budak-budak kan tak pandai menipu. Okay, boleh try. Sedap tak?
Berapa tahun dia?
Dia 9 tahun. Ha, sedap tak?
Laju terus.
Ha.
Macam kan? Snack dia makan.
Memang, budak-budak anak saya memang suka. Dulu tak macam ni. Dulu dia orang macam liat sikit lah nak makan sayur ni. Tapi Alhamdulillah, ni sebab dia cakap manis. Tapi macam kita tengok lah, saya mana ada letak apa pun. Letak garam, letak bawang putih dengan olive oil. Yang tu je. Sebab saya cakap bila kita masak dalam controlled temperature, dia bukan merosakkan nutrient and flavor. Dia macam release. Macam enhance the flavor dengan nutrient. Yep. Saya ada bagi thumbs up lagi.
Cahaya, thumbs up.
Okay.
And lemonade you tadi dah habis ke?
Oh, dah habis dah. Kasih kat budak-budak.
Tak apa, boleh buat lain. Boleh buat lain. Okay, next we go to Dr. Nora. Hang pi mana lagi Dr. Nora?
Ada.
Okay.
Nak tengok hak mana satu dulu. Adik, mari sini, dik.
Oh, semua pangkat panggil anak. Laila, you next.
You tak ready pula. Okay, ni yang bihun goreng tadi kan.
Dr. Nora bungkuk sikit. Tak nampak muka, nampak hidung.
Okay. Hidung mahal. Okay. Ni, bihun goreng ya. Bihun goreng blender. Okay, tak kita dah plating. Tabuk lah bawang goreng. Anak aku main dah. Okay. Nampak? Cantik kan? Nanti mereka tak sabar nak makan tengah hari. Okey, makanan tengah hari dah siap. Yang kecil ni, dia actually dah buat round pertama dah makan ice cream tadi. So,
round one, round two.
Wow.
Banana.
Kira ice cream cone kan? Belasah dia pakai spatula. Ni pun tak apa. Janji. Jadi,
nampak cecah lato.
Sedap ke tidak? Cakaplah sedap ke tidak? Cakap rasa dulu.
Kenalah rasa dulu.
Bagus.
Bagus.
Okay, dah pergi makan. Dah pergi makan. Okay.
Dr. Nora, siap. Boleh tak minta satu favor yang orang yang nak tengok bihun tu kan, boleh tak you tarik sikit?
Oh, tarik. Sungguh lah kan. Tak nampak. Ish, apa kan?
Bongkok sikit. Tak nampak. Nampak hidung.
Bongkok habis lah ni. Tak tahu kamera aku tiba-tiba menunduk.
Dia rukuk. Dia rukuk.
Sat-sat lah tu dia. Sebab banyak bahan atas ni. Jadi orang ni nak tarik tu tak sat-sat.
Tarik sikit lah. Je cukup. Nampak. Nice.
Tak putus.
Nice. Berat eh. Banyak barang lah tu.
Okay, belah ni sebab tadi banyak cabai-cabai. Tu dia beratnya.
Yang jatuh ke tu?
Nampak baiklah doktor.
Nampak hidung.
Okay. Thank you doktor. Thank you so much. Assalamualaikum. Now we go to Laila. Very nice.
Oh, so, hi. So this is my bun. Ada lagi dalam ni?
Banyak lagi.
Ini. Banyak lagi.
Laila, boleh tak tengok pau you? Itulah.
Yeah. Buka sikit. Yeah.
Bagi air rasa sikit, okay? Makan sikit, ah.
Kenapa dia orang buat macam ni kat kita, Aida? Kenapa dia orang makan kita?
Lunch sorted. Okay.
Well done. Tadi you pre-clean, apa dah jadi?
Nak tunjuk ke?
Mm-mm. Sebab lagi-lagi untuk mak-mak kan, mak dan ayah-ayah, kita malas nak nak basuh.
Dah siap dari tadi lagi dah sebenarnya, Cik.
There you go. Mak nampak kan?
Sekejap, boleh.
Let me tuang ya.
Yeah, let's boleh, tuang.
Yeah, I'm going to bowl so that you see.
Thank you sangat korang kena membasuh korang punya bowl eh. Lepas ni. Check it out korang. And this is a very nice angle, Laila. Very nice. Dah sudah.
There you go. So lepas ni just sikit-sikit je lah. Tak payah nak apa. It won't take so much time to clean it.
Yeah.
So that's the water. Almost jatuh. Okay.
Thank you so much. Korang nak tak cuba buat Anis Nabila punya butter chicken recipe ni? Siapa yang belum ada Thermomix tu? Maybe this is a recommended recipe to try eh. Aimi, ada tak Aimi kat sini? Masa kita unbox awal-awal dulu, this is the one that we make masa nak buka puasa. Very nice. Thank you, Laila.
Welcome. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. So with that, Aida, I think we are at the end of the show. Thank you so much, thanks, everybody, for joining. And I'm just going to display all the names yang kita ada tadi. I ada 13 nama. I ada 13 nama. Korang tengok nama korang ada tak kat sini. Advisors, please take note. Shika, you also need to take note of your customer. If I ada miss nama, cuba korang tulis dekat dalam chat. But in fact, tadi Kartini, branch manager boss, are you still here?
Yeah.
Jadi I rasa ada a few people still need to confirm. Diorang tak boleh nak commit to this particular show right now. Jadi kalau diorang still nak order end of today tapi I tak letak nama kat sini, boleh tak?
Boleh, as long as it's by end of today. So this is like macam a precondition punya hosting gift kan? Yes. Pre-hosting gift, yes. So it has to be confirmed by today and you have to submit your order by today, okay?
InsyaAllah. Okay. So I hope all of you are able to do so. Guarantee tak menyesal punyalah. Mungkin akan menyesal tak beli dari tak beli. Okay. Alright.
Pijak menyesal tak beli awal.
Ramai yang tu kita banyak testimonial kan, menyesal tak beli awal.
So Ijal, kita dah cakap pasal esok, kalau macam hari ni tengok rasa macam tak puas nak tengok lagi,
I boleh cakap pasal beli. You cakapkan sementara I cakap.
Okay, so kalau hari ni tengok tak puas lagi, so basically kalau you nak tengok lagi macam mana esok hari Ahad, sebenarnya is a special show only for customer. So kita ni ada cook along lah, kita masak together-gather dengan kita punya customer. Sebab tu best jadi customer pun and share ni. Macam-macam sharing kita ada share. So untuk hari esok kita ada Harlina dengan Shasha, our advisor akan share macam mana nak buat tahu belauk dengan apple nectarine lettuce pie. Nama nak sebut pun macam susah, tapi nak buat tak susah, insyaAllah. So kalau saya kata you need a little bit more confirmation, esok boleh join our session. Ask the links from your advisor, because this is supposed to be for our customer only, tapi we extend to all of you too yang masih tertanya-tanya. Betul lah Pijah?
Betul sangat-sangat. So don't miss out. You boleh dapat the link from your advisors, okay? InsyaAllah. So okay, then I think that's about it. So thank you so much everybody for still tuning in. And I think that's the show we have for today. My fellow presenters, especially Dr. Nora yang asyik hilang. Saya pun tak tahu dia pergi mana.
Yeah, ada.
Okay, so with that, jom kita bye-bye.
Multitasking.
Dah biasa macam tu kan?
Only with Thermomix.
Only with Thermomix. So dengan itu kita tutup bicara untuk hari ini. Thank you so much everybody for joining. Terima kasih daripada Cook and Share Branch. Do ask your advisors. Advisors will be calling you or contacting you right after this show to help you to understand further if you have any further question. Please tanya diorang apa sahaja hati you nak tanya. Okay, please go ahead. You need to be an informed customer. We want you to be an informed customer and hopefully you will join our community soon. With that, on behalf of Cook and Share Branch, I'm Pija signing off. Thank you so much. And I have Aida to say bye.
Right, bye guys. Thank you. Good evening.
See you. Bye. Thank you.
Bye. And thank you, everyone.
Bye. Bye. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed the show.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.
Salam Thermomix. Saya tiba kan?
Boleh pun boleh. Alright. Thank you, Tini. We can end our stream.